In this video, we are gonna walk through the pathway of blood flow through the heart. Hey there, friend. My name is Christina Raffano from nursingschoolofsuccess.com, and today in this video, we are gonna walk through how the blood moves through the heart and through the body step by step. So we're gonna break it all down super, super easy for you, and I'm gonna give you a ton of memory tricks to really help you remember it for nursing school. So if you like memory tips and tricks, definitely be sure to subscribe and hit that bell because you never wanna miss out on a video with even more nursing school tips. All right, so let's take a look at the heart. Now, the heart is divided up into four main chambers. You've got the right atrium, the right ventricle, the left atrium, and the left ventricle. Now, the right side of the heart pumps blood to the lungs, and the left side of the heart pumps blood to the body. Now, to help you remember this, think right for respiratory, R and R, and left as in L, as in literally all the other things. So that's how I remember which side of the heart pumps blood where. Think right for respiratory and left for all the other parts of the body. And when you think of the heart chambers, you have two atria and you have two ventricles. Now the atria are on top of the ventricles. So think A comes before V, right? So the atria are on top of the ventricles. You've also got a few valves here as well, the tricuspid valve, the pulmonic valve, the bicuspid valve or the mitral valve, and the aortic valve. Now, the two valves that nursing students get confused with the most are the tricuspid valve and the bicuspid valve, which is also called the mitral valve. So there are a few ways to remember these. The tricuspid valve is on the right side of the heart. So think that you always try to do the right thing. So the tricuspid valve is on the right side of the heart. So you try to do right. And the tricuspid valve comes before bicuspid valve. So for this one, you can think either try before you buy, or you can think you ride a tricycle before a bicycle. So tricuspid comes before bicuspid. And the last thing you need to know before we dive in is that the arteries carry blood away from the heart and veins carry blood to the heart. Now, the blood flow loses pressure as it moves through the body, right? So the veins have valves that keep the blood from backflowing. So in order to remember all of this, I like to think that arteries move blood away from the heart, arteries and away, and veins have valves to keep the blood moving to the heart. So arteries away and veins for valves. Alrighty, so let's draw this out. We'll start in the right atrium where the blood just came in from the rest of the body and it has given away all of its oxygen and is now what we call deoxygenated blood. So it doesn't have any oxygen. Now this deoxygenated blood flows from the body to via the inferior and the superior vena cava and from the coronary veins through the coronary sinus, and it gets dumped right into the right atrium. So blood moves from the right atrium through the tricuspid valve and into the right ventricle. Now from the right ventricle, it moves through the pulmonic valve into the pulmonary artery. So pulmonic as in pulmonary and into the lungs. So think pulmonary for the lungs. Now, the lungs then do their job, of course, for gas exchange, and they put more oxygen into the blood, making it oxygenated. So the blood now has oxygen in it, so it is oxygenated blood. Then from the lungs, the blood moves into the pulmonary veins, and we know that veins go to the heart, right? And the blood moves into the left atrium, moves through the bicuspid valve, aka the mitral valve, and into the left ventricle. Now from the left ventricle, it moves through the aortic valve and into the aorta, and then out to the rest of the body. Now obviously, you can think aortic valve for aorta, so that's pretty easy to remember. And that is the pathway of blood flow through the heart. Great job, my friend. Now, did you like this video? Let me know. Hit that like button. Share this video with your friends that may also need some help with this concept. And of course, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell so you never miss out on a video that we have for you here. Thank you so much for watching. Now go become the nurse that God created only you to be. And I will see you right here next time on the Nursing School Show. Take care.